Hey there. Today, we're going to talk about brushed versus brushless motors and show exactly how they work. I'd like to thank our Friends of CircuitBread, Orion fans, for their help on this video. Their support for this topic makes sense as the majority of a fan is the motor in it. So let's jump into it. The world of motors is broadly divided into brushed or brushless, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. For our purposes today, I'll focus on DC motors, not AC, though we're planning on comparing those soon. I'll start with brushed motors as they are the older technology and they're still both common and cheap. Brushed motors like these are inexpensive motors you can get from nearly any hobby shop. They're easy to control by changing the speed by either modifying the voltage or using pulse width modulation. If you want it to spin in the other direction, simply reverse the polarity. There's really only four pieces of the motor and no electronics. First, you have the stator, which is the stationary part of the motor and is typically made up of permanent magnets, though it could be an electromagnet in larger industrial motors. Then, the rotor, or armature, is the rotating coil that generates a magnetic field when current is flowing through it. The commutator is a mechanical switch that switches the direction the current flows through the armature. Finally, the brushes, from which the brushed motors get their name, are the contacts that transfer power to the armature. Let's see this work in action. So you apply a voltage to the motor terminals and a current starts flowing through the brushes. The brushes make contact with commutator segments, completing a circuit through the connected armature winding. This current then flows through the rotor, which then creates a magnetic field. This generated magnetic field interacts with the magnetic field created by the permanent magnets, causing a force on the rotor, spinning it. If the current direction in the rotor didn't keep changing, the motor would stop spinning once the magnetic fields were aligned. The commutator is there so the current direction flips at the right time, keeping the rotor turning. So when it spins, it shifts the commutator so that the brushes are touching a new set of bars that are wired in reverse of the previous bars. This causes the current to flow the other direction, changing the magnetic field, and causing the rotor to spin more. This happens over and over again, causing things to spin continuously. You can see that this is very simple, but as you can imagine, those brushes will wear out with time. Also, as the brushes are moving between points on the commutator, you'll sometimes get arcing. Overall, brushed motors don't last nearly as long as brushless motors. Brushless motors are more complicated, more costly, but have a lot of benefits. I'm using this example from Orion fans that I oh so gently disassembled. You can see that there are many similar parts, but they're arranged differently and there are some driving electronics as well. But a key difference is, obviously, the lack of brushes. Just like with a brushed motor, the brushless motor has a stator, which is almost always fixed. Next is the rotor, which is the permanent magnets and, in this case, are mounted inside the fan blade itself. Now, instead of having brushes and a commutator, you have an electronic controller that has some sensors and logic in it. The controller detects or estimates the location of the rotor and then, using switches, changes the polarity of the stator as necessary. The changing polarity, driven by electronics versus a brush and commutator, causes the motor to continue to rotate. Since there are fewer touching parts and the power can be applied more precisely, brushless motors are more durable, efficient, and they don't have any arcing during normal operation. But their active electronics are also a large drawback, limiting their temperature range, requiring a steady power source, and additional circuitry to accomplish speed control. Finally, brushless motors simply do not react in the same way as the more well-known brushed motors, which may confuse people who don't know why a brushless motor behaves the way it does. However, both brushed and brushless motors have their uses. Brushed motors are great for cost-sensitive or simple applications, but brushless motors are becoming the standard for high-performance, efficient, and long-lasting systems. Again, I'd like to thank Orion fans for helping us develop this lesson and providing me a brushless fan that I could destroy to help better show you what's going on inside a motor. You can support us here at CircuitBread by learning more about Orion fans either at their friend page or visiting their website. If you found this video useful or interesting, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we will catch you in the next one. Take care. Hey, we hope you enjoyed the video. Did you know that CircuitBread.com also has a ton of other stuff, including free electronics and electrical engineering tools? Besides a scientific calculator, we have a few dozen other tools, including a delta Y calculator,
LED resistor calculator, a binary, decimal, hexadecimal, and more converter, as well as a slew of other unit converters. Go check them out.